Hi, I'm Josh Joseph with the Peoria County Soil and Water Conservation District. Today we'll be looking at a denitrifying bioreactor built recently here in central Illinois. This bioreactor was installed to help address some of the nitrates leaving the field and tile water. Anywhere there's drainage, there's a possibility that excess nitrates are leaving the fields with the drained water. To find out what a bioreactor is and how it works, we talked to Austin Ramirez, an engineer with the Natural Resources Conservation Service.
A bioreactor is a tool we have to treat water coming off of agricultural fields. Nitrates, while good for crops, can be harmful to humans and the environment in high concentrations. What the bioreactor does is it provides an environment for microorganisms to treat the nitrates and break it down, convert it into non-harmful gas. The water is then allowed to re-enter the downstream water system clean and with reduced nitrate levels.
What we have done here is divert most of the water coming through the underground tile lines in this field into a denitrifying bioreactor. All of the tile lines from the field flow into one main tile line that runs all the way to the lower end of the waterway behind us. Water from the tile outlet goes into the road ditch. However, here, just upstream from the bioreactor, we have installed a device called a water control structure. This structure allows us to redirect flow from the tile line into the bioreactor. The bioreactor is a pit filled with a source of carbon, in this case wood chips. Naturally occurring microorganisms will use the carbon as an energy source and treat the water before it flows back out of the bioreactor through a second water control structure and into the ditch. What does this mean? When the water comes into the pit, it is carrying some nitrogen in the form of nitrates. These nitrates can be carried into our streams and rivers, causing problems. In the bioreactor, the naturally occurring bacteria will colonize the wood chips, reducing the nitrates to nitrogen gas, so the nitrates are no longer a problem.
Here they have dug a pit 19 feet wide by 76 feet long by 4 feet deep. How do we decide what size to make it? Well, the pit was designed so that the bioreactor would be able to treat 15% of the water the tile system can carry when it's flowing full. Now, 15% doesn't sound like a lot. However, most of the time, the tile flows well below full capacity. So most of the water coming off this field will flow through the wood chips and be treated.
Before the pit was dug, two water control structures were installed. The first water control structure allows water to be diverted through a T installed just before or upstream of that structure. Boards inside the structure block the direct path of the water through the tile line, diverting it through the T into the bioreactor instead. The second structure takes the treated water and outlets it back to the ditch. It also helps the farmer control how much flow goes through the bioreactor and how much time the water spends in the wood chips. Let me show you how these structures work. The structure is set into the tile line and connected through ports on either side. Water flows through the structure via these ports. If you look down inside, you see the structure is fitted with a series of boards set one above the other. Here you can see the boards being shut, blocking the flow of water through the structure. If the drainage system is flowing full, sending more water down the tile line than the bioreactor can handle, the excess water will flow over the top board of the structure, back into the main tile line and outlet in the road ditch.
This particular bioreactor has two separate water control structures, but it's actually possible to use a single structure with more than one set of boards to combine the work of two structures into one.
When the water flows into the bioreactor, it goes into a distribution manifold, a perforated pipe that distributes the water across the width of the bioreactor. The water passes through the wood chips in the bioreactor, and as it does, we want the water to be in the bioreactor long enough to be treated, but not too long. So the bottom of the pit is sloped just a little towards the downstream end of the bioreactor to allow the water to drain out after being treated. A second perforated pipe, called a collection manifold, is set across the width of the pit at the downstream side to collect the water after it has made its way through the wood chips. This collection manifold allows the treated water to drain out through the second water control structure. Under the manifolds, you can see a plastic liner, The liner is installed after the pit is dug, but before the pipe is laid, to prevent the soil and wood chips from mixing. The plastic liner also helps to make sure the water stays in the wood chip chamber long enough for the microorganisms to treat the water. Once all of the plumbing is in place, the contractor fills the bioreactor with wood chips, the carbon source for the microorganisms. The wood chips are mounted a little higher than they will need to end up being, because they will settle over time. Some bioreactors are left open with wood chips all the way to the ground surface for easy access should more wood chips need to be added later. However, for this particular project, we capped the bioreactor with soil excavated from the pit to prevent surface water from the field and the nearby waterway from entering the wood chips. A layer of geotextile fabric separates the soil from the wood chips. The soil is mounted up as well to prevent surface water from the field from entering the bioreactor. Finally, the cap is smoothed out and seeded to grass. The wood chips in this bioreactor are expected to last at least 10 years. Researchers have had bioreactors in place for even longer. Work is still ongoing to determine how long the wood chips will last.
It is important to use wood chips that will allow water to flow through and not become clogged. So avoid wood chips that are too fine or contain dirt or leaf litter. Microorganisms also need to be able to survive in the wood chips, so no treated or painted wood. Redwood and cedar should also be avoided for the same reason. The bioreactor is generally a low maintenance practice. Maintenance on a project like this can include regular mowing and managing water levels. Some bioreactors are designed so that the boards never need to be adjusted. Others are designed so the boards in the structure can be adjusted to manage water levels during the growing season. The bioreactor works well with other conservation practices, such as implementing a nutrient management plan, planting cover crops, and doing drainage water management. If you're interested in learning more or in finding out what technical or financial assistance may be available, contact your local NRCS or SWCD office.